sometimes one. So you people supposed to believe that there is work in power. Power of God is working. Power of God is working. And don't criticize pastor anymore. Since I'm born again, I give my life to God. I will never criticize pastors. They are really helping people. They are trying. Apostle Suleiman is a man of God. He's trying. People coming out, when anything just happened, you say they want to. They can never bring Apostle Suleiman down no more. No more. The way you are talking about Pastor Suleiman, the way the church is increasing, members of people are coming. Because he is doing the right thing. These evil people will try to bring him down, but they cannot, because anybody God stands for, nobody can bring him down. You can say anything in your social media, or so what you call. Pastor Suleiman is a real man of God. And that the woman have even confirmed that, yes, Pastor Suleiman is an innocent of what the man is talking. We know that you said you've been with Pastor Suleiman for 16 good years. 16 good years can be yesterday. But if you have that faith, then you will know that you have been with Pastor Suleiman for even for a long time. 16 years. 16 years indeed. Because he never helped you. Because he never buy a airplane for your private jet. That is the reason you are jealous. Look at the way your wife is talking to you. If you are a responsible pastor, you will not even bring this matter to the public. You will settle the matter amicably. But coming out to destroy the man of God, you are destroying yourself. You are really destroying yourself. Pastor Suleiman has a beautiful wife. Even more than that, your wife has a beautiful wife with quality. So now you are coming out just because of one thing or another, criticizing man of God. If a pastor, like last time, they say Pastor Suleiman bought a jet, private jet. There are some of actors, all those big musicians, they have private jet. What did you do? Congratulations. Davido, congratulations. This one, congratulations. So when a pastor have a private jet, and then you say, yes, he has done that, he has done this, please. I want everybody that call himself church goer. If you know you are a real servant of God, there's no way you would discriminate pastors. Always believe and God will still do yours. If pastor buy a private jet, maybe by tomorrow you will come and buy more than private jets. So always pray for people. Always encourage pastor, because they are trying. To go to Bible, read all those verses and begin to pour it on you people. You think it's easy? It's not easy. It's good for you people to believe a man of God. Anyone that you see that, yes, are you God? Why are you judging them? Why can't you stand like them and bring them to that level and say, change if they are fake, if they are that? Are you God? Are you the one to judge them? Judge yourself first before you judge others. If you cannot judge yourself, then don't judge other people. I want to use this medium to tell you that leave Apostle Suleiman Johnson, leave that man alone. He's a true man of God. This man that is just carrying fake news, it's like you are tired. You are tired. You want to destroy man of God. You can never destroy man of God. You can never destroy, because God have stand for him. Right from birth, he started preaching. Right from birth, he was going to a bishop Idahosa church. Right from birth, he know how to read and write. Right from birth, even the mother told him that he's going to be a pastor and a wonderful pastor. So why are you coming now to destroy him? You can never destroy him. Like Otubu the other time. Otubu was shouting. Then I challenged him. I said, Otubu, please, stop humiliating man of God. Then later he now come out to say, please, they just form it. Me and my boyfriend form all this allegation about Pastor Suleiman. So now you are still coming up now to destroy real man of God. Pastor Suleiman is a real man of God. He's a real man of God. If you don't believe, it's like you never know anything about God. You are still a church goer. All those church goers, we have to bring them to a table to preach the word of God to them so that their ear, something that open, their closed, something that closed their ear, it will be open. Because many of them are just going to church. They are church goers. Sometimes when certain things happen, they will just come out and say, ah, blah, 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 as if they are speaking in devil tongues, not God tongues. Because those people speak in devil tongues, we know them. Those are the people that destroy the pastors of the world. Pastors is like a cake to everybody. Go and do it. It's not a taboo. It's not a force. It's not, nobody is forcing you. Go and do it. Preach the word of God. Tell people that this is what you know about God. Like what happened? There is a woman that dreamed God appeared to her. That this is, God is coming. God is coming. Jesus Christ is coming back again. He's going to pick those people that believe in him. People that don't still yet not to believe. It is your own cup of tea. Nobody's going to force you. Nobody's going to take care and said, believe on Christ. It is your own mind. It is your own decision. It is your own life. If you believe God, you believe. But if you really believe in God, things in your life will be changed. I know there are some difficult people, they will come and challenge you. They will want you to commit something that, you know, that you don't really want to do. May God forgive them. But those people that said yes, they will not, they don't want anything forgiven except they want to impress or oppress you. May God destroy them in Jesus' name. Amen. So brothers and sisters, like what Pastor Suleiman was saying yesterday, he said a woman